Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing a demonstration wash on this General Electric washing machine that I just purchased with a pretty unique load. I got two pillows on one side, I got a quilt on another, and I also have a fitted sheet just below it. Everything tucked on that left side there is basically shorts and shirts. So this is like a load for my son. With some pillows and some garments and such. So I have in the dispenser a loaded pod and very little liquid softener. So I'm gonna go ahead and shut it. Automatically turns on, one of my pet peeves. But we are gonna go ahead and select a cycle. What cycle should we select? Let's see. Oh, I guess I'll do quick wash. I will have it at soil level. Heavy. Can do cool on this load here. Spin, we'll do more, but not max on this unit. We'll do deep fill so we can get a little bit extra water in there. You can also have the option to power it off without affecting the time. Deep rinse, it says here, set when adding fabric softener. So we got fabric softener in our little compartment. Yep, we're gonna wanna leave that on. Otherwise, you run that cycle, that's gonna be sitting with softener in there. So let's go ahead and get started. Alright everybody, so of course the reason why I'm doing this video is to demonstrate how something like these high efficiency washing machines get an often bad rep for going off balance. So I thought, well, this is an unusual load, you know. Let's record how it behaves during the wash cycle, and you decide for yourself whether this is something that will work for you, your family, your circumstances, because you know, you will be loading your washing machine unusually sometimes, and this goes a little bit further than just watching wash rags, you know. So hope you enjoy. Hope maybe this helps you make an informed decision to know how many videos out there you're able to compare them with. But this is going to be the General Electric GTW720 something 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 high efficiency direct drive 4.8 cubic foot washer, washing two towels, bed quilt, fitted sheet, normal sheet, some shorts, a shirt. Yeah. Thank you. Now, one thing that I really like about this washing machine, if you're still with me, is that it's very quiet. You know, I've heard some Maytag Whirlpools, and they sound kind of grinding, but you know, this is a very quiet direct drive motor. You don't hear it much. Now, GE doesn't get a good rep when it comes to these high efficiency washing machines, I guess, in the washing world. But I gotta admit, I'm impressed by this washing machine. It doesn't get enough rep. I don't see a lot of it being promoted out there. But it's really good, actually. I love all the presets that you can customize your wash cycle. I mean, if you saw my first video, you saw how much options there were that you can select simultaneously. And I feel like other washing machines kind of limit the usability. I like how GE kind of approaches it. But the question is, how does it hold up during the high spin cycles? Alright, so before it goes in a spin cycle, let's take a look at the dispenser tray. Alright, so we had a pod here, we also had softener. We're about, I'm not entirely sure how many minutes we have left, but here it says it's going to go into the rinse cycle, spin cycle. Let's see how much what we have left in here. Okay, so completely dispensed, and we still have our softener sitting there. So let's continue. To the rinse cycle with 20 minutes left on your dump. Minutes left on the clock. All right, let's check on what that did. So that dispenses your softener. So now it's been rinsed with softener and everything does definitely feel moist. Okay, let's get back to it. Now we're entering the last 11 minutes of the cycle. Thank you.
8 minutes left.
But the question is, how loud is it? So this is with the phone on the lid, resting on the lid with a light on it. So let's take it out. Okay, now we're about, give or take, 4 feet away. Right? Not too far, but you guys, hopefully you learned something new about this washing machine. I hope it helped you make an informed decision if you're currently in the market. And if you are not in the market, but will be in the future, consider subscribing to our channel. So that way you can stay informed on our GTW720 top load washing machine long term on there. You know, we've had it since December. So December to now, 7 months, and no problems yet. Consider subscribing. Alrighty, these are the last 4 minutes of the cycle. have it. Two pillows, a couple quilts and sheets. And there you go. Well, everybody, hope you enjoyed the video. Please consider subscribing and leave any comments in the comment section below. If you liked the video, go ahead and like it. And thanks again. Have a great day.